Good morning, students of class 9. You are welcome back to the online portal e-classes. So now let's continue our lesson in history, socialism in Europe and the Russian Revolution. We have learned about socialism in Europe and we are learning socialism in Russia. So now here 2.3, we are coming to the end part of this part, subtitle 2.3, socialism in Russia. So now, in our previous class, we have learned that the factory workers, especially the metal workers, they considered themselves as aristocratic because of their skill and talents. They were considered high or superior than the other workers who were uneducated or who were laborers. So factory workers, and we have talked about them, and we have talked about the peasants. In the countryside, most of them were illiterate, most of them were poor, so they have other type of opinion. So now let us make it more clear. Number one, Social Democratic Workers Party. So in this Social Democratic Workers Party, actually they are the factory workers. These Social Democratic Workers are the actually factory workers, especially the metal workers who thought that they were superior than the other workers. So they formed one party, Social Democratic Workers Party. And these factory workers, you can say that in simple words, factory workers disagree with Socialist Revolutionary Party. Who were Socialist Revolutionary Party? Socialist Revolutionary Parties were the people of the villages. People who belonged to the villages, and they wanted to have the land from the nobles. So these were Socialist Revolutionary Parties. So this Social Democratic Workers Party disagree with these Socialist Revolutionary Party. Means the factory workers were disagreed. They disagreed with the village peasants, because the villagers or the peasants wanted the land from the land should be given to them, so from the nobles. So they disagree with this village peasants part about peasants. So they disagree about the peasants. Now here number two, Lenin. The meantime, this one great leader, his name was Vladimir Lenin. Lenin felt that peasants were not one united group. In the villages, Lenin thought that the villagers or the peasants are not united group. They are not one united group. Some were poor and the others were rich. Some worked as laborers and others are capitalists who employed the laborers. So they are not one united group. There is a lot of differences. So due to these differences, Lenin thought that they could not all be part of the socialist movement. So Lenin thought that you cannot have a movement with all these kind of differences. So in order to become organize a successful movement, all the people should be united as one group. But here you can see a lot of differences. So they cannot all become the part of the movement or socialist movement. Lenin thought that. So that means they have to be trained, they have to be united, combined as one. Then only the movement will be successful. So Lenin thought in this way. Vladimir Lenin, his full name is Vladimir Lenin, who led the Bolshevik group. So now there were two new social classes or social groups emerged. One was Bolsheviks and the other was Mensheviks. Now you see there are various groups. Now just now we have talked about Social Democratic Workers Party and we have talked about Socialist Revolutionary Party. Now here comes another one, Bolsheviks. Who were Bolsheviks? Bolsheviks were the peasants from the villages. Most of the peasants, they belong to the Bolsheviks. Vladimir Lenin, who led the Bolshevik group, he was the leader of the peasants. Lenin thought
that in a repressive society, the society was very repressive under the Tsarist government, under the nobilities, under the clergies, under different social groups, that in a repressive society like the Tsarist Russia, the party should be disciplined, the members, they have to be disciplined. Without discipline, they cannot achieve their success. So the party should be disciplined and should control the number and quality of its members. The quality and the numbers must be controlled. So first of all, they have to be disciplined, and the numbers have to be controlled, and even the qualities. So number and quality of its member should control. They should control. Now, number in the sixth point, others who does not agree with Lenin, they thought, no. All the people should be considered as Bolsheviks, or all the people should be taken as their member. So other Mensheviks, other group of people, you can see Mensheviks, thought that the party should be open to all, not only the quality and the quantity. They should not control quality and quantity. All the members should be allowed to join the party. So these people who thought in this way, they were called Mensheviks. Bolshevik thought that their number and quality should be controlled. They should control the quality and the members, quality and the quantity. But Mensheviks thought that all should be included, or the party should be open to all the people, and they were called Mensheviks. You can see that. Here also Bolshevik and Mensheviks, their views, both of them were peasants. Bolshevik were also peasants, Mensheviks were also peasants, but the views differed. Bolshevik, they wanted their members, they should control the number and the quality. But Mensheviks thought that the party should be open to all. So let's see what happened. To be continued. That's why in our next class we'll have 2.4. We'll go to the point 2.4. We have finished 2.3. At turbulent time. Turbulent means kafi, lot of disturbance. A time of disturbance. A turbulent time. 1905 revolution. Now we'll go to the Russian Revolution of 1905 in our next class. A time of lot of disturbance, a disturbing time. 1905 revolution in our next class, 2.4. We'll be doing that. Don't miss the class. You go through the online e-classes every day so that you'll not miss a lot of things. Otherwise, you'll get confused. You go through the book at home. You go through the point 2.3. Now in our next class, we'll go 2.4. So according to that, it will be much clearer to you. If you go through the book, it will refresh. As far as possible, I'll explain everything in the class, but you need to go through the book at home also. You need the reading. Your reading is quite poor, as well as your writing is also not that good. You must improve your writing and reading. So at that you can do at home. So in the e-classes, you can pay attention, listen carefully, try to understand the subtitles. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching so attentively and paying so much attention in the class. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next class and continue our lesson in 1905 revolution. That's all for today. Thank you very much.